Great sun rising, people of life, light in the dark. The truth is being revealed to you daily. And we know the truth of this various isms and sects and secret societies. And we know that they're all lies. We know that there are lies. And lies is what their world is built upon. So in this particular article, it's talking about who Trump has lined up as one of his first nominees. And probably the who is actually going to become the Supreme Court's new judge, one of many. So Trump is expected to nominate Amy Coney Barrett to the Supreme Court. Now I want you to see that they're just holding true to their lies and their existence as being a reality. We know that, excuse me, family. When we know that it's all lies and it's an illusion. The federal appellate judge is a favorite of the religious right. So pretty much they're just holding up their lies in their society. And not only their lies, but the greatest sin, the greatest crime against humanity was when these group of newcomers came in and decided to write into existence their world of existence, which is wickedness, full of unrighteousness. But we know in science and in nature, there's often, too often, opposites and oppositions. So Judge Amy Coney Barrett at the Federalist Society's 2019 National Lawyers Convention in Washington. Samuel Quorum, The New York Times via Redux. Okay, President Donald Trump is expected to choose Judge Amy Coney Barrett, whom he previously appointed to the United States Court of Appeals for the Seventh Circuit to replace the late Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. News outlets including CNN, PBS, NewsHours, and CBS reported Friday evening that the president is expected to announce Saturday that he has chosen to nominate Barrett to the nation's highest court, though the pick isn't yet final until Trump makes a formal nomination. Okay, he's supposed to be announcing this today. Last night he was in Newport News, which is not that far from me, a good 15-20 minutes, less than 20 minutes away from me. Actually, me and the children were down at the airport where he actually arrived last night, and you know, doing our regular ride the bike and exercise, walks and runs. So Trump announced that he was going to be announcing this today. Now, while I don't entertain contracts and paperwork and Moore's, because Moore's feed into these people's reality, which is non-existence. It's an illusion. Something is built off of a lie. It can't ever exist as reality. It's always going to have a falter in it. It's not going to be anything upheld. It's not going to be anything upright. It's always going to have a struggle. A lie brings struggles. Remember that, family. Okay, so Barrett is a staunch Catholic, a favorite of the religious right, and a former law clerk to conservative Justice Antonin Scalia. Her judicial record is fairly thin, owing to the fact that she's only been a judge for about 3 years, but of course we know her background as a lawyer. But that short record suggests that she'll be a reliable conservative if confirmed to the Supreme Court. In one of the most revealing opinions, Barrett took an expansive view of the Second Amendment, dissenting to the right of two colleagues who were appointed by President Ronald Reagan. Before joining the federal bench, Barrett was a law professor at the University of Notre Dame, and she frequently weighed in on many of the cultural fights that animate religious conservatism. Okay, so she was a university professor. In 2013 speech on Roe versus Wade, Barrett reportedly stated that life begins at conception, a common view among abortion opponents. But, you know, for Black people, we should never partake in any of this. This is not us. This is not our struggle. This is not our way of life. This is not us. But we're out of our element. We're out of our estate, our proper person. And it's, I don't mean by paperwork either, and the little nationalities that these people created. I don't mean by that. I mean something greater. We're out of our estate, who we are. We're out of that place. And a name and an ID does not give us that. It just gives it for you to integrate into a society that is a lie, an illusion, more illusion. This is why I don't subscribe to the Moorish things, paperwork, because they forget about the science part of it, the most important part of it. She signed a 2012 statement claiming that an Obama administration policy requiring employee health plans to cover conception was a grave violation of religious freedom and cannot stand. See, us subscribing to their thinking makes us white people in Black skin, figuratively speaking, okay? Because I know some people are going to argue that we don't have Black skin and they don't have white skin, but when it comes to our melanin, it could be anywhere from a dark black to browns. And we know browns can be green, like yellowish, brownish, green. Okay, so we get that. She also signed a 2015 statement to Catholic bishops endorsing the church's conservative views on abortion, sexuality, and marriage. See, we never had to face any of this stuff, but we make it our problem because what we've been through with these people, what they have done to us is they have infringed upon our ways, their ways. And so these issues, we allow to become an issue for us, where in our reality, if we knew that our great-great-grandparents went through slavery and they knew the difference between being like the white people and being who we are, in some cases, they got it. They got it. They saw the difference and they said, we're not that. We're not that. And they groomed us to not be that. But somewhere down the line, politics played a big part. Not only politics, but entertainment and a lot of other stuff played a big part in making us feel like and think that we are them. So we take on these abortion issues, sexuality issues, marriage issues, and we never did have to deal with that before. until we decided to integrate with them. Some will argue and say integration was all about sexuality, about being sexually capable of getting connected with whiteness. And I would say I would have to agree with that. And then, you know, we noticed that our marriages declined and men in the household declined and stopped being men to build families, men building families to men gone their own way. It's just a disgrace in this day and time. And in 2017 book review, Barrett seemed to criticize two Supreme Court decisions that largely upheld Obamacare against partisan attacks, suggesting that she is likely to vote to undercut the Affordable Care Act and potentially strip health care from millions of Americans in the process. Well, millions of us don't have health care. And frankly, I prefer not to have health care because I know, looking at the illusion that I'm in, that they really can't really do the things that I need for me, for my health, and my children's health. So I'm more with the natural health care. If I have a naturalist, I would prefer to have a naturalist as a doctor than someone who is practicing something that they don't even know or get down well. They're just practicing on you in everything they do. And it's a crying out shame. But I digress. Barrett's views are hardly atypical of a Trump appointee to the federal bench, and her professional credentials, while impressive, are shared by many other sitting judges. It's likely that she rose to the top of Trump's Supreme Court shortlist, not because her record sets her apart from a dozen or more staunch conservatives on the federal bench, but because of an effort by Democrats to impugn Barrett's fitness for the bench when she was originally nominated to the Seventh Circuit. That botched effort allowed religious conservatives to paint Barrett as a persecuted martyr and means that Trump's choice of Barrett could double as an attempt to stroke resentment among Christian conservative voters shortly before the election. Barrett's 2017 confirmation hearing was a disaster for Democrats. Barrett is devout Catholic. Okay, she's a devout liar. She's a devout killer of millions and millions of black babies, children, women, men, all over the place, all over the planet. Because as we know, Catholicism gave birth to all the other religions that are lies. There are death traps for our people. And I was meaning to talk about this yesterday, about how some people die thinking about the things they were taught in church. And it's lies. So when they die in a lie. And I think that's one thing that really gets me the most. Is that most of our people are dying and they're expecting something and they don't know what to do when they die, when they pass, because death is an illusion in itself. And if we know the truth, then we know what to do when we do have an unfortunate, untimely death. And she often grounds her conservative political views in her faith. She even co-authored a 1998 law review article exploring how Catholic judges should behave when the law's demands come into conflict with their religious beliefs. That somewhat dated law review article played a starring role in opposition research memos, and other documents circulated by liberal groups opposed to Barrett's 2017 nomination to the federal bench. Many of these groups feared that it confirmed Judge Barrett would place her personal oppositions to abortion ahead of her judicial obligations to follow Supreme Court decisions such as Roe versus Wade. It is a fair game to criticize a nominee for their political beliefs, including their opposition to abortion, and it is fair game to criticize someone for political beliefs that are inspired by their religious faith. But it's a disastrous hold up here. This is why they separated church from state, state from church, because they didn't want us as Black people to see the hypocrisy in it. But they are mixing church with state. Regardless, they still do it. But in a disastrous, they just don't want us to, because they don't want us to wake up and recognize the truth. Exchange with future Judge Barrett during her 2017 confirmation hearing, Senator Dianne Feinstein. Senator Dianne Feinstein appeared to go a step further, seeming to attack Barrett's Catholicism itself. In the coming weeks, expect to see a short clip from Barrett's 2017 hearing over and over again. Dianne Feinstein, I'm going to play this video real quick.
The dogma lives loudly within you.
Okay. During Barrett's 2017 hearing, Feinstein, the ranking Democrat on the Senate Judicial Committee, drew a distinction between law and religious dogma and accused Barrett of applying the latter when she should apply the former. The dogma lives loudly within you, Feinstein told Barrett, and that's a concern. It was a remarkable tone-deaf remark, and it helped transform the obscure law professor turned judge into a celebrity among the Christian right. Feinstein, meanwhile, was cast as something akin to a tyrannical imperator tossing innocent Christians to the lions. The notion that Catholics are as so beholden to Rome as to the incapable of rendering independent judgment in public office has a long sordid history, wrote the Catholic conservative writer Sohrab Ahmari in the New York Times op-ed attacking Feinstein. The origin of the dogma debacle appears to be an article titled Catholic Judges in Capital Cases, which Barrett co-authored with law professor John H. Gravey in 1998. Gravey is now the president of Catholic University. In that article, which was published shortly after Barrett graduated from law school, she and Gravey suggested that Catholic judges may have to recuse themselves from death penalty cases when their religious convictions against the death penalty conflict with their judicial obligations to enforce laws that provide for capital punishment. The article also mentions the Catholic Church's absolute opposition to abortion. Many of Barrett's opponents characterized this 22-year-old article as evidence that she would place the teachings of the Catholic Church ahead of her obligations to follow the law. As one liberal group claimed, Barrett wrote specifically about the duty of judges to put their faith above the law. The often explicit fear underlying statements such as this one was that Barrett would undermine the right to an abortion if confirmed to the bench. Had Feinstein merely expressed concerns about Barrett's views on abortion, perhaps the future Supreme Court nominee would not have become such a celebrity among Christian conservatives. But by blurring the line between the legitimate attack on Barrett's political views and an illegitimate attack on her Catholic faith, Feinstein transformed Barrett into a hero for religious right. Barrett has very conservative views on issues like abortion, LGBTQ rights. Barrett often expresses conservative political opinions in explicitly religious terms. In 2015, for example, she signs a letter to Catholic bishop that endorsed many of the church's conservative teachings on abortion and sexuality. Now, for many of our people who subscribe to being the white ways of life, this is actually what I call a good thing to keep them in an uncomfortable place. What I mean is the fighting between a house of people, a group of you know, race of people, fighting in-house amongst themselves, is causing a catalysm or a catastrophe on the outside of them for us, for our people who have been too comfortable in whiteism and the ways of a life, the lies, the illusion. And it's causing them to be discomfort. They're going to be in so much discomfort that everything's going to come to a head eventually. Eventually. We give witness that the church's teachings on the dignity of human person and the value of human life from conception to natural death, on the meaning of human sexuality, the significance of sexual difference and complementary of men and women, an openness to life and the gift of motherhood on marriage and family founded on this indissoluble commitment of a man and a woman, provide a sure guide to the Christian life, promote women's flourishing, and serves to protect the poor and most vulnerable amongst us. This letter reference to the value of human life from conception to natural death leaves little doubt that Barrett personally opposes abortion, and his statements regarding the complementary of men and women in marriages and family founded on the indissoluble commitment of a man and a woman suggests that Barrett personally opposes marriage equality and potentially opposes extending other rights to LGBTQ. But we see so far that this is definitely nothing connected to us as a people. Our blackness is life. Blackness stands for life. And what we need to do is we need to go our own way as black people on this planet. And we need to stop looking to these people as if they have something. And we need to stop looking outside of ourselves for the Messiah and realize the Messiah is within us. And ain't nobody going to come to save you, but they sure did come to destroy us. So with that said, family, I'm going to leave this in my video comments. I'm going to leave this in there. So with that said, true love, real peace, and the higher self within the soul. Till next time.